Jai Hind, my dear children. We are continuing the second chapter, electric potential and capacitance. Now we can study the next topic, electric potential due to uniformly charged thin spherical shell. So in Gauss's theorem, the last chapter we have studied what is electric field due to a thin spherical shell. Here we can study electric potential due to thin spherical shell. So consider a thin spherical shell. This is a thin spherical shell and charges Q are uniformly distributed on its surface. And R be the radius of the shell. P is a point distant r small r from the center of the shell. So we have to find out electric potential at three points. First one outside the shell, second one on the surface of the shell, and third one inside the shell. So case one, potential outside the shell. Electric potential outside the shell. Okay. We have electric field outside the shell is given by the formula E equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R square. Electric field at a point outside the shell is E equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R square. So this we have calculated from Gauss third application. Okay. And we have potential difference and electric field are related by dV equals minus E dot dr. E represents the electric field, dV represents the potential difference. Here dV can be written as minus electric field. What is the electric field here? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R square into dr. Now we can find out the total potential by integrating. So V equals integral minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R square into dr. So minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0, it's a constant, it can be taken outside. So minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 integrating R raised to 2, R square, if it is taken to the numerator, R raised to minus 2 into dr. Integral R raised to minus 2 dr is Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0. Integral R raised to minus 2 dr can be written as R raised to minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. Okay, so here minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Here minus negative. So both can be cancelled and we can write V equals Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 R raised to minus 2 plus 1. So that is R raised to minus 1. So V equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R. So potential at a point outside the shell is given by V equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. So the charges are uniformly distributed on its surface and the potential outside is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. That means even though the charges are uniformly distributed on the surface, the effect is at the center. Right. Next, case 2. On the surface of the shell. Potential on the surface of the shell. Okay, so on the potential surface of the shell, what is the only change? P is shifted to here on the surface. So small r becomes capital R. Okay, so on the surface of the shell, small r equal to capital R. Therefore, potential can be written as directly we can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by small r can be substituted as capital R. So Q by R. Okay, so potential on the surface of the shell is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R. Then last case, case 3, potential inside the shell. Okay, again we have the formula electric field equals minus dV divided by dr. So electric field is the negative potential created. Here also we have taken the same formula dV equal to minus E into dr or E equal to minus dV divided by dr. From this we can write dV equals minus E into dr. Clear. Here, what is electric field inside the shell? Electric field inside the shell is zero. So, electric field inside the shell is equal to zero. This is from Gauss's third application. This is the Gauss third application. Electric field inside the charged spherical shell equal to zero. And hence, dV can be written as zero. Because E equal to zero, dV equal to zero. So, potential dV represents a potential difference, isn't it? So, potential difference is equal to zero means potential remains a constant. And what is the constant value of potential? V is same as that on the surface. That is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by capital R. Potential on the surface is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by radius. And similarly, potential inside the shell is also V equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by R. So, potential on the surface and inside the shell are constant. But in the electric field inside the shell is zero, that we know. Now, if a graph is plotted with ray r along distance along the x-axis and potential along the y-axis, potential distance graph. If potential is plotted along the y-axis and distance is plotted along the x-axis, this is the charged spherical shell. This represents a radius. So, we know that inside the charged spherical shell, potential is constant and surface also same value. Okay, inside and surface, potential has the same value. So, we can draw the graph like this. So, up to the surface, potential remains constant. And what is the value of constant? V equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by capital R. And beyond the radius, okay, if smaller is greater, smaller as distance increases, what happens to potential? Potential goes on decreasing according to this formula. As R increases, V decreases. So, beyond capital R or radius, what happens to potential? Potential goes on decreasing. It is inversely proportional. Okay, and the formula is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by small. So, here the position R less than capital R. Here, small r is equal to capital R. Here, R is greater than capital R. Okay, so that is the potential at a point due to thin spherical shell.